You know, I'm the type of guy that would want to have a baby shower with you too. I just always envisioned those types of things. I wanted to be the hands-on dad. You know, part of decorating the nursery. Just every little detail. So I'm happy that I can be a stepdad to Junior. And I'm happy that you're pregnant, especially after what you went through with your last baby. But I'm scared, Miranda. So what if it's not mine? Like, let's be realistic here. I am infertile.
Naturally, you're gonna have your doubts. I'm gonna have days where I doubt things, but I wanna have a positive pregnancy. You know, I want us to enjoy it together. And remember, after Joey, I took a plan B.
Yeah, I know. But you also threw up after taking plan B. Look, I want it to be my baby. I want that more than anything. I just don't want to get my hopes up. I don't want to be disappointed.
Look, I don't know if you're a spiritual person or not, but I am. And like, I genuinely feel in my gut that it's yours. Like, after we did what we did, I just felt something different, if that makes sense.
Well, even if it's not, I know you're divorced from him. I'm already a stepdad to Junior. I want it to be my baby. I want it more than anything. In my gut, yeah, I feel like it is my baby. But if it's not, I'll take care of it like it's my own.
I promise you, Brian. Trust me, by the end of this pregnancy, you're gonna be a dad.
You know, when I was with Shay, and we spoke about the nursery stuff and all that, she told me it was her job to do that, not mine, that the man doesn't do it. That killed me. So I'm happy to decorate the nursery with you.
Hey, Ma. You know Miranda's been hiding something from me?
Yeah, that's nothing new. Did you figure out how you're gonna get me my visitation rights for my grandson? Did we figure out that situation?
You just listen. Apparently she gave Junior like a slushie and it's got something in it, glycerol or something, that made him sick. He's okay, but she had to take him to the emergency room. He was in the hospital for a day. And she told me after the fact. She should have been calling me while she's in the hospital, right?
You know, sometimes she just makes stupid mistakes. She doesn't realize how big a hole she digs herself, but who cares at this point? What are you gonna do?
What do you mean, so? We have a custody case, you know? Even though I only have 2 days visitation rights, she's still required to tell me what's going on with my son, and she waited a week to tell me. So you know what I'm gonna do? I'm documenting it. I'm documenting every little thing that she does wrong. And I'm gonna tell them when the time comes. Look, she didn't tell me my son was in the hospital.
It's just funny how, no, it's more ironic how she can get on me for giving Junior cereal too early as a baby, and yet he's going to the hospital because she doesn't know what's in a slushie.
She's a lying hypocrite.